Becoming nobody. That's been the recurring theme for me. You know, I was a pastor for many years and been doing spiritual teaching for many years. And it's interesting that through all of that time, you look back and you realize that even though there was some incredible wisdom, that below the surface, there was still a level of trying to be somebody through the teachings of surrender and non-attachment and all of those incredible things. But you realize, you know, there was still an element down there that was trying to be somebody. Some level of recognition or validation. And I know it's interesting that I'm filming myself doing this, but I've taken time away from this because the invitation is to become nobody, but to re-enter with a different sort of heart posture. Because friend, I realize that you're a person watching this. I'm not just speaking to my camera in my living room. You're a person with real desires, with real fears, with real emotion, with real letdown, with real virtue. That you're someone who has a deep capacity for love and for creativity and for art and innovation. You're a person who has a particular level of energy and aptitude to bring things into the world that were not there before. And it's a unique thing to engage any of those and to participate in the flow of life while still holding ourselves in a place that is not attached and not clinging to any of those things to bring the validation or the recognition that we think we need. And so I make this video, friend, to help unbuckle you from the burden of any of those things bringing definition to who you are. If what we do nestles down into love and service, then we can find all of the expressions that desire to emerge from us. But if what we do, what we desire, comes from the desire that is, let's use a word that's not very popular, unholy. Let's bring some definition around that. Unholy. What does holy mean in the first place? Holy means set apart. And there are desires in our hearts that are holy because they're set apart from the pattern of the game of this world. And things that are unholy, if you will, are things that are being used for purposes that are according to a pattern that it is not supposed to be a part of. When you see a mandala, and it's this beautiful pattern, it's obvious to see if there is anything that does not belong in the pattern of the mandala. That thing would be considered, if you will, for the analogy's sake, unholy. Not that it's wrong or sinful. I come from Christian tradition. People are obsessed with that. I don't think they know what sin really means. Sin just means to miss the mark. That's literally what sin means, to miss the mark. So to be not in tune, to be not in flow, to not be a part of the pattern is unholy. It means that it's taking something that might even be good, but putting it into a pattern that it's not supposed to be a part of. And so for each of us, we have to take an inventory and ask ourselves, the things that we are doing, are they rooted in love and service? Or are we trying to be somebody because we think that is who we should be? And it's time to release and unbuckle from expectations and understand where the fountain is within you that wants to pull up goodness and give your gift from the true place. So a few notes from the field today. The feelings of being an imposter come whenever I feel that I have to be somebody. There's somebody that I need to become. And this is sort of my issue with self-development. To develop the self is to imply that you need to become somebody that you're not already. And the reality is, you have to uncover who you really are. Your true self may express itself in a much different way, and it could look on the surface like you've become somebody else, but actually you've become who you've been the whole time. And so this idea that we have to become someone, that we have to be an artist, we have to be a creative, we need to become a business person, we need to be an influencer, we need to be a disruptor, we need to be someone who's a mover and a shaker. The idea is that we need to abandon something within us to move into that. And my argument is that you don't have to abandon any of who you are. That as a matter of fact, if you do abandon and betray who you really are, then none of that will be sustainable because it's not actually coming from the place of truth that's within you. It's coming from the place of lack to need and create a truth. And there's a huge difference between the two. To live your truth, to excavate your truth, to live into the fullness of who you actually are, is not to become anything other than yourself. And so much of our culture and society wants to tell us that we need to live your truth, but they're trying to get you to buy into a particular truth to live into and to sell, essentially. And I'm here today to tell you that you, friend, do not have to become anything other than what you are. If you are an artist, if you are a creative, if you are a business person, that will be the natural outflow of you connecting to the deep, true self. That will be the progression that is there already. And to try to become anything else will only leave you in a place of pain and suffering because it's not natural to who you are. The outflow of who you are will be natural, but you have to be honest about the way that you are wired and know that there is no title, no role, no function that's going to bring you satisfaction. You living into you is true satisfaction. And as you live into you, the natural outflow and result of that might have some titles accompanied with them, that is that of artist or business owner. But it has to be from the natural outflow. The fountain, the essence of it has to come out of who you truly are, or else that well will dry up, because there's only so much that you can pull up that's not true to you. There's only so much that you can excavate that's not true. And at some point that's going to run out, and at some point it'll hit the bottom, and at some point it will not be able to sustain anymore. And the reason that we see depression and anxiety and burnout and insecurity is because people have not tapped into the fountain that is eternal within them. And they continue to go back to places that have limited resources. And so you watch more videos and you watch more things and you do more businesses and you try to create this in this way because you think that's the secret sauce. You're the secret sauce. And all that comes out of you from that place might find its categories in familiar places. But we can't start there. We got to start in here.